morning, everyone. Happy Monday. Well, Cakes for Causes does such great work with so many different organizations. We know that. We get the pleasure of not only learning how to make a sweet treat, donuts, each time they come on the show, but we get to hear how their work helps others.
Absolutely. And certified baker Jeannie Trader is here with us this morning. And Jeannie, we love when you're on.
Oh,
because
thank you.
You always leave us with something yummy to eat.
Well, yeah, that's our little bribe.
I mean, Cakes for Causes, we know by now, is just an amazing organization that works with other amazing organizations. Yeah. Now, one of those recently was the Eric Height Foundation. Tell us what you did with them.
Yes, it was. In the spring, they had their annual 5K family walk run, fun walk run. And we provided street treats for all the walkers and runners that day. So, and we work with them on, partner with them on other projects throughout the year as well. They're one of our regulars that keep coming back for our sweet treats, so it's always fun. And we also did a Desert Voices event up in Phoenix, because as you know, we're up in Phoenix as well. We've done 3 Make-A-Wish cakes in the past month, and past couple months. So that was a real pleasure. It's a real treat to be able to work with that organization. And we always have our birthday cakes on call hospital program for the birthday cakes for the children in the hospital. And our kids club is always a lot of fun too. So it's always a lot of things going on.
I love that. And we're looking at some of the pictures of the Make-A-Wish cakes, and they look so adorable.
Aren't
I'm sure
cute.
The kids were just so ecstatic to see that. And speaking of birthday cakes, you guys actually, we showed one of your birthday cakes on Friday. You did Ken Carr's birthday cake for us with beautiful Ken's face on it, our executive producer. There he is.
Right there.
With his beautiful cake. So we thank you guys so much for that. And I love how much you guys do for everyone. And did I read this right that you guys have something that's called a cupcake necklace?
Cupcake necklace. I'm wearing it today,
yeah.
One of ours. It's done in our logo, in the Cakes for Causes logos. It's with the purple with the green sprinkles on it. And we have them on sale on our website. They're really just
Look how cute that is.
They're on sale on our website, $25, and that includes shipping, and we get a portion of the proceeds. They're made by Jen at Bakery Charms. She graciously donated her talent and offered to do these for us in our logo colors. And it's a nice fundraiser. And you get to wear this adorable little cupcake around your neck.
I know. It's just so cute.
So cute.
And what a great way to help support this wonderful organization. Because, again, you don't charge these companies
for these sweet treats. No, we don't. All those proceeds go to buy more ingredients. So nobody gets paid. We're all volunteers. So, yeah, and it just helps us move forward to the other nonprofits that we work for.
Well,
so it helps them with their mission.
And then you share your love by coming on here and showing us how to even make more sweet treats. So today we're making donuts we could do at home?
That's right. Yes, these are baked donuts, so they're not fried.
Okay.
Oh, so
I love
these
that.
Are a healthier donut. And this is a really, really quick recipe. I got this off of sallysbakingaddiction.com. So I don't believe it's up on our website yet, but if you go to sallysbakingaddiction.com and just Google or search for donuts, you can probably find this recipe. You want to start with your dry ingredients, which I have in here is a cup of flour, all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda, and 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg. That nutmeg is what gives it that little donut flavor.
Okay.
Okay. And so then you just mix that together. You want to combine all those things. And then you want to mix up your wet ingredients, which is going to be 1 egg. It's half a cup of buttermilk.
Oh, buttermilk.
Yes.
And 1/3 cup of brown sugar. You want to mix those things together and get those combined. And then when those are combined, you want to add 2 tablespoons of melted butter and 1 1/2 teaspoons of vanilla.
Okay. This doesn't look that hard.
It's not. It's a very, very simple recipe.
Because usually baking is an overwhelming thing for me.
No, this is so simple. And you're going to add your wet, and it's called the muffin method. You're going to add your wet ingredients to your dry, and you're going to mix those. A little hint about buttermilk, if you don't happen to have buttermilk at home, or you don't want to buy buttermilk just for this, if you add 1 tablespoon of lemon juice or vinegar, start with that, and then add enough milk to make a cup, and just let it sit for about 5 minutes, and it'll start to curdle just a little bit, and you'll have buttermilk.
Wow.
That way you
what
don't have to go
tip.
Buy the whole quart.
Do you know what? That's really great, because I think some people do think that if I buy a whole thing of buttermilk, just use what I need for the recipe, what am I going to do with the rest of it?
Exactly. Well, and speaking of that, you can actually freeze leftover buttermilk.
Oh,
you can freeze milk and then just thaw it out and you can use it again.
Use it later.
Do that.
For another batch of donuts.
Exactly. So you just want to mix it until it's just combined, and this is about it. You don't want to overmix, because if you overmix it, then you're going to get a real tough donut.
Okay.
This is
going
to make a real light, airy donut. Another hint for filling these little donut pans, because as you can see, it's very thick.
Right.
And then you're like, how am I going to get that in there?
Right.
You're
going to
spray this with nonstick spray. Mm-hmm. Take a glass and put your Ziploc baggie, if you don't happen to have a pastry bag like the others do, put a Ziploc bag. Just fill your bag.
We're going to kind of make a, what are they called? The, is it a piper?
Yeah, you're just going to use your bag to pipe it in.
I like how you looked at me to tell you. I've never even seen a donut pan before. I didn't know these existed.
And this is a standard size. I do make the mini ones, too.
Okay.
And you're just going to snip off the end, and then you're just
going to
pipe
them in.
It in.
Oh, that
and
way you don't make a huge
nice
mess.
And you can also use the electric donut machine over here, too, if you have one of those.
Oh. And this is what it looks like when it comes out of here?
Yes, 350 degrees, 9 to 10 minutes. That's all it takes, 9 to 10 minutes, and you've got these beautiful cakey donuts.
Nice little quality there. And now we can kind of decorate them with any flavors and designs
That's
we
right.
Want.
We've got some chocolate, vanilla, maple glazes. We've got lots of nuts and sugar toppings.
Ooh, yeah.
Do you have any advice on how to put the frosting on?
Yeah.
Make a mess.
If you just want to take, we're going to do, just use your fingers, and I just dip it
Oh, dip it. Oh,
okay.
Just dip it, just you want, because you just want to dip in the top.
I'm doing my maple.
And then you can just use your fingers to sprinkle whatever sprinkles you want.
Ooh, oh, baby, that looks
okay,
good.
Okay, so that's pretty good.
And I'm doing cinnamon sugar.
I'm so impressed.
I'm going to brush it with some butter, and then I'm going to put it on, sprinkle cinnamon sugar on mine.
Oh, kind of reminds me of like a cinnamon toast.
I have some pralines here.
So we could do nuts, we could do sprinkles, chocolate, any
kind of
frosting.
We've got toasted coconut there, and I was thinking with the maple glaze, bacon.
Some coconut.
Right? Fry up some chopped up bacon.
Did she say bacon?
Yes.
On top of the maple.
Absolutely.
Would that not be delicious?
Why wouldn't you do that?
That
why not
amazing.
Exactly? I mean, you're saving calories by baking the donuts, so go ahead and splurge on the bacon.
Hey, I love that.
You're speaking my language. I love this. We always love when you guys come on. I love that the recipe was so easy. Just go get yourself, one of the pans that you can do the donuts, and then the kids will love these.
That's right.
And then you're saving a little bit in there.
Right.
And the kids can play along. Yeah.
Yes, and decorate them.
And you only get like 8 to 10 donuts, so it's just enough for your Sunday morning, and it's perfect.
It is great.
All right, let's try one of these. Are you gonna try one?
I actually want to try one of your maple ones.
All right, try that one because it's nice and right there in my hands.
All right, well I'm gonna try this. You want to read my?
Sure.
Talk about fundraising.
Well, Jeannie, thank you again for coming today. It's just
such a pleasure
to have you every time you're on. And now listen, the food fundraiser will be at Jason's Deli near Tucson Mall on July 22nd. That's from 5 to 10 p.m. You can also find out what other events Cakes for Causes has coming up by calling 303-7893, or you can check out their website, cakesforcauses.org.